In this video, we discuss about measure of dispersion. We already seen that measure of central value gives a single value which represents all the data, but sometimes an average cannot adequately describe a set of observations, mostly in the case when we have same central value for different set of observations. For example, let's take three different sets. We can see that for each set the mean value is 50 and the variance is different. In the set 1 there is no variance, and in the set 2 and 3 the variance is large. Also we can see that in the set 2 there is no single value near the mean. So we say that measure of central tendency are not sufficient for having some idea about the data, and such variants are called dispersion. There are four commonly used measure of dispersion, that is standard deviation, mean deviation, quartile deviation and range. Here we discuss about mean deviation, called as average deviation or first moment of dispersion. Let's see the formula. Now here we consider mean, median or mode as capital A. We have two types of data, only observation and frequency distribution. In frequency distribution we have ungrouped data and group data. Now the formula for only observation mean deviation, that is 1 upon n summation absolute xi minus a. Here capital A is mean or median or mode, and small n, that is total number of observation. In frequency distribution the mean deviation is 1 upon capital N summation fi into absolute xi minus a. Capital N is addition of all the frequency, and the coefficient of mean deviation is mean deviation upon capital A. Also note that mean deviation about median is least compared to the mean deviation about mean or mode. Let's see the example. Now here we have only observation and we have to find mean deviation and coefficient of mean deviation from median and arithmetic mean. So the mean deviation about median, that is 1 upon n summation absolute x minus median, and the formula for coefficient of mean deviation about median is mean deviation about median upon median. So first of all we have to find median. Here we have total number of observation, small n is equal to 11. Now we arrange all the data in ascending order, and n is equal to 11, so we have single middle value, and that is 40. So median is equal to 40. Now for absolute x minus median, for this value we calculate 8 minus 40, as here x is 8 and the median is 40. So 8 minus 40, that is minus 32, but we have to consider absolute value, so it is 32. Then for this value the calculation is 20 minus 40, that is minus 20, and absolute minus 20 is 20. Similarly we can find the remaining value. Now add all this value, so the summation value is 179, and we substitute this value in the formula of mean deviation about median is equal to 179 upon 11 is equal to 16.27. So the mean deviation is 16.27. Now the coefficient of mean deviation about median, that is the mean deviation is 16.27 and median is 40, so 16.27 upon 40 is equal to 0.41. Now also we have to find mean deviation and coefficient of mean deviation from arithmetic mean. For that, the formula are this one. So we have to find arithmetic mean, and we have only observation. So the formula of arithmetic mean is summation x upon n. Here summation x means addition of all the variable, that is 4, 6, 7, and small n is 11. So the arithmetic mean is 4, 6, 7 upon 11 is equal to 42.45. Now we calculate absolute x minus arithmetic mean. Yeah, arithmetic mean is 42.45, and for this value x is 8, so 8 minus 42.45, that is minus 34.45, but for absolute value it is 34.45. and for this value the calculation is 20 minus 42.45, that is minus 22.45, and the absolute value is 22.45. similarly we can calculate the remaining value. After that add all this value, so the summation value is 181.45, and now we substitute this value in the formula 181.45 upon 11 is equal to 16.50. So mean deviation about arithmetic mean is 16.50, and coefficient of mean deviation about arithmetic mean is equal to 16.50 upon 42.45 is equal to 0.39. okay, let's see one more example. Now we have frequency distribution, and we have to find mean deviation and its coefficient from the arithmetic mean and mode. Now the formula are mean deviation about arithmetic mean, that is summation f into absolute x minus arithmetic mean upon summation f, and the coefficient of mean deviation about arithmetic mean is equal to mean deviation about arithmetic mean upon arithmetic mean. So first we find arithmetic mean, and for frequency distribution the formula is summation fx upon summation f. Now here addition of all the frequency is 50. Now for fx we multiply all the frequency with corresponding variable, that is x. So for this value 145 into 4, 580. Then for this value we calculate 155 into 6, then 165 into 10, 175 into 18, 185 into 9, and the last one is 195 into 3. Now add all this value, so summation fx is equal to 8560. Now we substitute these two value in the formula of arithmetic mean, so the arithmetic mean is 171.2. Now we calculate, first we calculate absolute x minus arithmetic mean, then we multiply this value with corresponding frequency. So first, for this value, the calculation is here x is 145 and arithmetic mean 171.2. So 145 minus 171.2 is minus 26.2, but the absolute value is 26.2. Similarly, next calculation is 155 minus 171.2. That is minus 16.2, and the absolute value is 16.2. Find the remaining value. Okay, now we multiply all this value with corresponding frequency. So for this value, we multiply 4 and 26.2. That is 104.8. Then for this value, 6 into 16.2 is equal to 97.2. Similarly, we can calculate the remaining value. Now we add all this value. So the summation value is 528. Now substitute this summation value in this formula. So mean deviation about arithmetic mean is equal to 528 upon 50 is equal to 10.56. And the coefficient of mean deviation about arithmetic mean is 10.56 upon 171.20, as mean deviation is 10.56 and arithmetic mean is 171.2. So the coefficient is 0.06. Now for mean deviation and its coefficient from mode, we have to find mode. And in frequency distribution, we need to find highest frequency. So here, the highest frequency is 18 and the corresponding x is 175. So mode is equal to 175. Now, we calculate absolute x minus mode, then multiply this value with frequency. So for this value, the calculation is here x is 145 and mode is 175. So 145 minus 175, that is 30. Then the next calculation is 155 minus 175 minus 20, but the absolute value is 20. Then the next value is 10, 0, 10 and 20. Now we multiply this value with corresponding frequency. So the first calculation is 4 into 30, 120. Then next calculation, 6 into 20, 120. Then 10 into 10, 100. 18 into 0, that is 0. 9 into 10, that is 90. And the last is 3 into 20, that is 60. Now add these values. So the summation value is 490. And we substitute this summation value in this formula. So we have 490 upon 50 is equal to 9.80, and the coefficient of mean deviation about mode is equal to 9.80 upon 175, that is 0.06. One more example. We'll see frequency distribution group data. Here we have to find mean deviation about median, and the formula is summation f into absolute x minus median upon summation f. So first we need to find median, and the formula is L plus h by f in bracket n by 2 minus c. Now for that, first we calculate cumulative frequency in less than form. So for this value, here frequency is 10, so the first value is default 10. Then for this value, we add these two frequency, that is 10 plus 25 is equal to 35. After that, for this value, the calculation is 10 plus 25 plus 30. But what we do, we add 35 and 30, because addition of these two values is 35. So we directly calculate 35 plus 30, that is 65. Then the next calculation is 65 plus 20, 85. And the last calculation is 85 plus 15, that is 100. Now, if your summation f, and here the last value is same, that means your cumulative frequency is right. Now, next we have to find cumulative frequency greater than n by 2. Here n is 100, so 100 by 2 is 50. And cumulative frequency greater than 50, that is 65. Okay. Now, the corresponding class is 20 to 30. So the median class is 20 to 30. In that, h is equal to 10 and l, that is lower value of the median class, so l is equal to 20. Now, the frequency corresponding to median class is 30, so f is equal to 30, and the cumulative frequency corresponding to previous class of median class, that is 35, so c is equal to 35. Now we substitute all these four values in the formula, so median is equal to 25, and we substitute this value in this formula, so mean deviation about median. For that, first we need to count absolute x minus median, and after that we multiply that value with frequency f. For that, first we need to find x. X means mid value of the class. Okay, so mid value of this class, that is 0 plus 10 by 2, 5. Then mid value of this class is 15, 25, 35 and 45. Now x minus median, x are 5, 15, 25, 35, 45, and the median is 25. So the first calculation is 5 minus 25, that is minus 20, but the absolute value is 20. 15 minus 25 is minus 10, and the absolute value is 10. 25 minus 25 is 0. 35 minus 25 is 10. 45 minus 25 is 20. Now we multiply this value with the corresponding frequency. So first, 10 into 20. 10 into 20, that is 200. Then 25 into 10, 250. 30 into 0, 0. 20 into 10, 200. And 15 into 20, 300. Now add this value. So the summation value is 950. and we substitute this value in the formula of mean deviation about median 950 upon 100. So mean deviation is 9.50. Okay, thank you.